Hi guys, today I'm going to show you a really quick and easy craft to make for your reborn girls. I made some headbands for my babies. So I made this one, this little tiara is for Maisie when she comes. I made this butterfly, and I made this bird. So I am going to show you how to make them. So the first thing you need is felt, and I just cut mine into these little squares, and just cut however many you need for your headbands. You also need E6000 glue, and I love these little tubes. It's a lot easier to work with. You need scissors. You need this elastic. It's thin braided elastic. And the package looks like this. I got this at Joann's Fabric. And you also need these little appliques, whatever you want. This one is by Simplicity Brand. And these are the iron-ons. So that is all you need. So the first thing I'm going to do is I am going to cut my elastic. Now I have my reborn. Let me see if I can get her into the shot. But I have Harper here. And big ol' head. You can kind of gauge how big the headband is going to be. But what I do is I still measure. I take this and go under her head, and you can kind of see it's going to go, hold on guys, kind of like a measuring band. You see right there how I have it stopped right there? That's what it's going to be where it ends, and then since it is elastic, I cut a little bit less than that, so that way it stays on their head real well, and it is, again, elastic, so it'll fit bigger babies. It's easier, so I would rather, you know, do it that way, and go just how a normal headband would go. So I am, and be careful of your reborn's hair, please. So I am going to cut right here, and this is our elastic band, how big it is. So I'm going to move Harper out of the way. Okay, and now that I have my band, we can put that off to the side, and I have my iron-on applique, and you can also use flowers and anything you want, but this one has like a soft background, and it's a little sticky. That's just because of the glue that was holding it on the cardboard, but they're very smooth, so that's good. So you're gonna place it there, then you're gonna take your glue and you're gonna put a dab right in the middle, like that. Then you're gonna take your elastic and place it in the glue. And what I do is I take the cardboard that I got my applique from, and I use that to push it into the glue, that way your fingers don't get messy. Then I use it to hold it so I can stretch. You can kind of see I'm stretching the elastic to make sure that there's no, it's not like turned, because otherwise it'll get messed up on the baby's head. So I just turn it like that so the other side is facing it. And then I put that part in the glue like so, and push it like that. Then my last step is to take my felt, if I can pick it up, oops, take my felt, and since there is excess glue, I don't have to add any, and I just push it down like that. That way the glue, and I take this cardstock, just quickly wipe off the excess glue. It just makes it look a little bit cleaner. There. So that is very simple, right? And the felt is a protector of your baby's heads, and just so the glue doesn't have an adverse reaction to the paint or anything like that. So I would wait about 15 to 20 minutes, preferably probably an hour, and before stretching it or doing anything like that. So make sure it dries, and then you get these adorable little stretchy headbands. And this is one that I did, and some of them I didn't put the cardboard or the felt because it's so thin, as you can see, and there's a little hole there. But I mean, I wiped it pretty clean, and so it won't make a mess. But I'll show you what they look like on the baby. You can kind of see what that looks like. It looks very sweet, and it's a very easy craft. It took like 5 minutes, if that. And I'm going to get some more. I bought some black elastic. I want to get some flowers and make some with that. They have thicker elastic, but I like the thin. It's just easier to work with, and it looks a little bit more babyish. But yeah, that's what it looks like. It's very sweet, and you can do this with all iron-on applications. You can use it with flowers, pretty much anything. I mean, anything that you can think of. And I just thought that it would be fun and a way to make headbands very cheaply. The elastic was like $1.53 or something, and each of the iron-on transfers was only like $1.99. So you can make a ton of headbands, and you can also even possibly use like the 3D stickers for scrapbooking, because they do have a backing on them. You could use that. Pretty much anything. I mean, your heart's desire is, your only limits. So I hope you enjoyed this video. I thought it was a lot of fun to do. I really enjoyed doing it. And thank you so much for watching. Macy didn't come today, but that's okay. I left the apartment, and it was my fault. The second I left the apartment, that's when she came. So I'm going to go pick her up tomorrow, and I will be sure to do a video on that. So yeah, that is my tutorial, and I hope you enjoyed it, and thank you for watching. Bye.